Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding always its master's voice written by Josie Joseph. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for political science and public administration optional students. Plus this is also very important from essay point of view. Now in yesterday's essay paper, we had around 3 to 4 essays that were directly related to the decode classes. The essay about capitalism and how this is not compatible with the inclusive approach, this was in the yesterday's paper, and I had discussed about this aspect in about 30 to 40 editorial classes. And another about the dream, I had been talking about the dream of India, and that was also in the essay paper. So if you want to crack next year's mains examination, so essay plays a very important role, and in order to have hold over the essay, you must watch these editorial classes, because the kind of the essays they are asking, they are actually very subjective and they require lot of thought development and analysis, which is possible only through the decode classes. So let us start with today's decode class. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the autonomy. This editorial is about the functionality. This editorial is about the personal setup. This editorial is about the financial independence of a specialized agency, that is Central Bureau of Investigation. Now when it comes to Central Bureau of Investigation, its cardinal role is to investigate the crime. Its cardinal role is to file an FIR. Its cardinal role is to present a charge sheet to the court, as per which the court will conduct the proceedings of the case. So, from the investigation point of view, CBI plays a very important role. CBI is nothing but a central police organization. It is a central police which is having lot of power. Now when it is a central police, it works under the aegis, it works directly under the control, it works under the hierarchy of the central government. And this institution explicitly, though it is not required to toe the direction, the line of the central government, but implicitly it had to toe. Because its entire personal setup, its entire financial setup is having a kind of a ubiquitous relationship with the central government. Now, as far as Central Bureau of Investigation is concerned, how can we make it more autonomous? Because there has been a hell lot of criticism against Central Bureau of Investigation. Now, the first thing that can be done to clean this institution is to create a specialized cadre. Now presently this investigation, though it is a very specialized activity of police, but in India we have not specialized this activity. So in order to give a kind of a professionalistic look to investigation, it is very important that we should come out with a specialized cadre of Central Bureau of Investigation. Now if you look at this entire personal setup in Central Bureau of Investigation, there are quite a number of posts in Central Bureau of Investigation that are lying vacant. We need to fill up these posts because there is a lot of pressure on Central Bureau of Investigation. And because there is a lot of pressure, the high-end cases, the cases related to the politicians, the cases related to the corporate tycoons, are moving at a snail's speed, which actually puts up a question mark on the functionality, on the legitimacy, and on the justifiability of this investigating agency. Now the second thing that needs to be done is to provide this institution a kind of a statutory status. It should be provide a kind of autonomy, a kind of independence, a kind of a leeway which is provided to Comptroller and Auditor General. Now because the executive will never be giving freedom to the Central Bureau of Investigation, because the freedom that it will be giving to the Central Bureau of Investigation, it would be taming, it would tame the executive. So executive would never have wanted itself to be tamed by an institution which is actually underneath it. So until and unless the institution is underneath the executive, it is not going to work in an efficient and effective manner. To introduce this efficiency, effectiveness and justifiability in its functioning, it's important that we should move its entire thing, the financial aspect, from the executive. The expenditure that it does, it should be charged upon expenditure, charged upon the consolidated fund of India, rather than from the consolidated fund of India. Because when any spending is done from the consolidated fund of India, it has to be voted on and it could be reduced. Whereas charge on expenditures, the Lok Sabha, it enjoys less rights and it gives more autonomy to the institution. Now the another aspect, that it should also lay its report in the parliament. If any institution would be laying its reports in the parliament, it would enhance its credibility, it would give a push to its stature, it would also put up a direct accountability and a direct control to the representatives of the people. So it will introduce a broader spectrum of control on an investigative agency. Now presently what is happening is most of the IPS officers, they are placed in the Central Bureau of Investigation, and when they are placed in Central Bureau of Investigation, they are actually at the fag end of their service. Now being at the fag end of their service, they are also looking out for some plump posts after their retirement, and because of that they generally end up towing the line of the current dispensation. And this is the reason why Central Bureau of Investigation was called, or is now also called, as the caged parrot. If you want to move the parrot, you need to take the wheel of this institution. Now, apart from this, we also need to enrich this institution of investigation by introducing more of technology, by introducing more of machinery and gadgets which can help the investigative agencies to conduct proper crimes, to conduct proper investigations. Because the type of the crimes that are taking place in the country, they are actually far ahead of the competency and the potency of this institution. If we want to match up with the crime, we need to give a kind of a push, we need to catalyze this institution. Now most of the personnel of the Central Bureau of Investigation, they are not having mobile phones, they are not having laptops. Leave aside the other investigating gadgets. So in order to give a push, we need to remodel, we need to restructurize, we need to revamp, we need to reorganize this institution. Only then it would be feasible to have a credible investigative agency in India. Now the another issue, most important issue about Central Bureau of Investigation is about the posting. We need to introduce the tenure system in CBI. The director should be given a fixed tenure of 2 years, so that its post is not as per the whims and the fancies of the dispensation. He or she should have the fullest of the autonomy. And a condition should also be placed. Anybody who is a director of the CBI would not be entering into any government job once he or she has done away with its tenure in the CBI. Only then we can expect impartial investigation. And an investigation is the most important aspect. if we want to tame the crime in our country, if we want to tame corruption in our country. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes or entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the class that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. And please do install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.